Hello, I'm John Robbins, the Chief Constable of West Yorkshire Police. We have an amazing new education resource created by West Yorkshire Police called Pol-Ed, Police Education.
The Pol-Ed resources provide a suite of resources which are free to schools that they can then adapt and use with their pupils of differing abilities and so on.
Pol-Ed has provided staff with an opportunity to use really fantastic lessons that comply with the PSHE national curriculum.
Including lessons around offences like public order offences, domestic violence, grooming, prevent, counter-terrorism, quite a number of offences really.
There's so many different lesson plans available. They're all sequenced and part of a bigger picture.
These resources can be used to provide information to teachers, deliver knowledge and skills of pupils on how to stay safe, protect themselves, make the right choices in difficult decisions, and also builds on their resilience and teamwork.
The essence of Pol-Ed for me is a professional, well-resourced programme of lesson plans designed by teachers that is delivered by teachers.
It's given teachers a starting point if they wish to create their own lessons and use the Pol-Ed lessons as a guide. But likewise, it's provided us with full schemes of learning for all of our year group.
It can be easily adapted, and there's so many different tasks within that that can suit your students. For example, videos, articles, and a lot of discussion and debate. Staff are able to identify how learning can be built upon and sequenced. So for example, if you start in it in year 7, it carries on right through to year 11, and you can identify how students are able to build on their knowledge.
I think the thing about the Pol-Ed scheme is that it can fit alongside any scheme that schools have chosen to use for RSHE and PSHE. I know that certain schools will be wanting to emphasise some aspects of the programme depending on their context, depending on the needs, the current needs of the pupils. And the thing with Pol-Ed is that they can select from it. It doesn't have to be delivered as a complete scheme. They can select certain units of work to go alongside the work that they're already doing.
It has been a perfect programme for us here at St. Plinus. The children themselves come from different backgrounds, mixed backgrounds, and some children experience a lot of personal difficulties and are exposed to crime situations at home. Their perception of the police can often be disjointed as well. So the programme has supported us as teachers to educate the children on the wider world and experiences they might be having to face, as well as hopefully change their perception that the police are here to support them and build more of a picture, a positive picture for the children of who they are.
We want to help teach young people about their rights, their responsibilities, how to look after each other. It genuinely is pioneering, and we're so proud of it and the people involved in it.
I think it's important for schools to teach young students about law and crime because a lot of students aren't taught about it at home. There's a lot of things I honestly didn't know were illegal, but apparently they are. So it's good that we're taught about that in school and we won't bring that behaviour into the outer world.
So what I like most about Pol-Ed is the scheme is really relevant to local and current issues that impact on our children.
What we're hoping to achieve with Pol-Ed is that all schools across West Yorkshire can have Pol-Ed as a baseline resource that links in with the personal social health education subject.
It's intertwined really well into our PSHE curriculum. We've embedded it all the way through, so it's a common thread for the teachers, for their teaching. So it's enhanced really more than anything the curriculum that we already have in place for our PSHE.
Pol-Ed really encourages our young people to understand exactly what they can and can't do in the eyes of the law, but also what they should and shouldn't be doing from a moral point of view as well.
Students learning about law and citizenship and how that helps students to understand the impact that a crime can have on society instead of just being really general and saying what is the impact of crime.
One of the units that children study links to home safety and how they can make their home extra safe. And I know that they did have a break-in in their house, and because of some of the measures that they'd learnt about within their Pol-Ed lesson, they went home and spoke to their parents and they were able to put that into practice.
Pol-Ed has a lot of examples that students can relate to, especially in a culturally diverse school, looking at race and religion and disability and gender orientation. I think the resources reflect that really well.
The Pol-Ed lessons have encouraged young people to think about issues that might concern them. It's also developed their leadership skills so they understand how they can make a difference in society. As a result, we've seen lots of our young people get involved in student leadership activities as well as volunteer with community initiatives.
For me, volunteering is really nice because I get to see many new people, many new faces, so I could know more about them and just communicate with them.
It's important to help your community because if you're getting like into criminal stuff or something bad, it can affect you and all the people around you.
You can access Pol-Ed by registering online. Registering for Pol-Ed is absolutely free for all schools within West Yorkshire, so you do not have to pay anything for it.
Right now, Pol-Ed is up and running across hundreds of schools, but it won't stand still. It's an ever-evolving programme that is being continually adapted to ensure that it meets the needs of young people and reflects the particular challenges they face. Together, if we get this right, this will help generations of young people. It will help them to keep them safe, both now and as they grow into responsible adults and citizens of the future.